everybody, welcome to John Creator. Today we are going to model a coffee cup so with our photo image. So let's go into the video. If you're new to the video, subscribe the channel and click a bell icon to get your new videos and other things. And then if you are very new to the beginner, please see my old video for the beginners. Let's start the video. Sorry, let's go into the video. Create a circle and go to the 7 and I scale it little bit up and zoom it here. So go to the front view, go to edit mode. Before that, apply a scale. So I think you'll be knowing why I'm telling about the scale. So scale has been changed. So I press Ctrl A and apply a scale. Now so it's this icon which is not showing correctly, right? So go to the screen casting and go move it 20 off your set. Okay, it is okay, and this is I'm going to make it as 40, and now not 40, 10, make it as 0, and I go to N to go up. Okay, I make it minus 20 and close and minus 40. Okay, and close. Okay, fine. Now it came correctly. So go to object mode, press 1 on the for the vertices and E to extrude Z axis, E to extrude Z axis, E to extrude Z axis. So E to extrude Z axis. Okay, now this one we are going to make slightly down. Okay, like this. This shape I'm going to do, I go to the top view and I go to the front view in wireframe mode, shift Z, and I select this and scale it slightly down. Now I do one thing, E to extrude and S to scale, E to extrude, S to scale, E to extrude, S to scale, and M to merge at center. And then I go to the solid view, go to the edge selection, I select these edges, Control B to bevel, and I create one 3 curves. Okay, now I go press Control 3 to shape smooth, go to this triangle icon and I select the auto smooth, and then I turn off this both, editing is not required on, so I offed it. Now right click and set smooth. Now our object has been created in the first shape. Go to the edit mode here. Before go to the inside mode, so I'm going to, okay, inside mode is required. Okay, let it be. And Z to wireframe, I go to the top view, E to extrude, S to scale, so I make this much big thick. E to G, okay, let it be the same. E to extrude, Z to scale, and I make it slightly inside. E to extrude, Z to scale, and slightly inside. E to extrude, Z to scale, and slightly inside. Okay, I exit it. S to scale. So now I make it more inside, and E to extrude, scale, E to extrude, scale, E to extrude, and scale. E to extrude and scale, and M to merge at center. This edges, so sorry, I'm pressing the G Z, you can move it slightly up, and Control B to bevel, make like this shape. So you can able to see inside, it looks like this. Okay, our cup has been ready with the top angle. In the top angle, I'm going to create one edge loops in between. So let me see how it looks. It doesn't look nice. Okay, and we can give some corner bevel for this to make it Control B to bevel, and I create like this. Yeah, it looks fine. So our coffee cup is ready with the basics. So now we can create a hand for this. I go to the edit mode and I go to top view and I select this thing for the straight, rotate using the control. I'm going to rotate it correctly, and this could be fine. I feel like okay, these two faces I'm going to select for creating a edge loops, and G2 towards to create one top here, and I press control R and I create one thing here. So instead of doing this, we have to make it even. So I go to the edge selection, select this one, control B to bevel, and I reduce the shots. One thing is required for us, so it will create the even size for us. Okay, now I press 3 on the keyboard for the face selection. I select these faces and X to delete the face. Okay, now here we are going to create using I press shift S and cursor to 3D. So our 3D cursor will be mentioned center here, so we can create one item here. Shift A and create a plane, and go to edit mode, select all. So sorry, all, it's already in edit mode now, right? I press control L to select only the face, the plane, and M merge at center. Now I press G to move, select these edges, and G to move. You can able to see one vertices is selected, so which is required for us. And I go to the, so instead of okay, we can do like this also. No, instead of doing like this, so I X to delete the vertices. I go to the object mode and I press shift A and I create a bezier. So I create a bezier and G Y to move, sorry, X to move. I go to edit mode. Now this is the bezier which is required for us, and instead of bezier we can create a path, right? So better it will be for us. So I go to the curve and create a path, and G X to move. So I move towards like this. I go to edit mode. You can able to see our path has been came like this. I go to the front view. Now I just move this here and select this one and move here. Select this one, move here. I make it this like this, so it will be nice. And I create like this, and this shape also let it be same. So actually cup comes like this, right? I know one thing, I create one subdivision here, right click and subdivide, and I just move this one like this. So for us it looks like this, it will be nice. Okay, so the shape which we are giving like this only here for this. Okay, this is not neat actually. I make it like this. Okay, so our cup handle has been, we are using this, we are preparing. I go to the object mode, object, set origin, origin to geometry, and I go to the tab, and now go to the curve section and go to the geometry, and we are going to add a object for this. Go to the normal edge selection, and I press right click, shift right click to move the, shift left click to move the 3D cursor, sorry, shift right click to move the 3D cursor. I create one circle, and I'm going to make it as 4, enter. Okay, now this one I'm going to use it here. So I go here and I select the object. Okay, it's not taken. So I do one thing, I delete this and I create a curve and create a circle. And okay, now I go and select this circle, sorry, I go to this and select this, and this circle I have created. Now we can give some depth for this. Make it as 10. So which is coming like this. It's very small, I think so. Yeah, it's very small for us. Okay, I'm going to make this little big. Okay, it's not happening. And I make it extrude. Yeah, fine. Now this, it has been created for us very well, and this resolution, what I'm going to do is I'm going to reduce this resolution to very less. Go to this and see this one, everything is fine. Okay, now we have created correctly. So now I reduce the preview resolution, and I am going to reduce the this resolution to, now it should be like square. Okay, which has been came square for us. This is the same I'm going to give, and this resolution I'm going to make it up. Okay, fine. Now which is bigger, now which we want a little more bigger the size is. So this one I'm making going to make it 2, and this one I scale it, sorry, I scale it. Okay, it's not happening. So what we have to do is we can try to extrude it one more 2 centimeter. No, it's not happening. So I make it 2. No, sorry, I select this one. Instead of circle select, I go for the normal select. Select this and make it extrude 2, 1 centimeter, and I delete this one. No, if I delete it, it's going on. Yeah, it's went. So it's not a big trouble for us. I make it 2. So it's extruding in this angle. Okay, right. Okay. Okay, I make it that it's ready be 0. And object and profile rounded. Okay, here we can increase the depth. So fine. So we can increase the depth here. So which is required for us the thickness as per our requirement. So okay, fine. So I make a little bit reduce. Okay, fine. Now this is ready for us. So this cup, what we are going to do is I'm going to shift right click and convert to mesh. So now it has been converted to mesh for us. So this way to create a one curved object for us. Okay, now I select this and I select this control J to join. Okay, now I go to edit mode and I select this face, so this one fill, and I'm going to select this one and this one going to fill, this one I'm going to select F. Okay, sorry, I make it this 2, 4, 2, make it fill, and this 4 to fill, this is going to fill, and let me see, oops, it's not coming correctly. I select everything, shift N to calculate inside, shift N, so I don't think I select all, shift N to calculate inside. So let me see, now it's came correctly. So this is the way to join a handle for the cup. Okay, same way I'm going to do this for here. So I select this one and this one. This one is 4. This one and this one, F4. Okay, so instead of this, I select these 3, F. So these 4 going to F. And these 4 going to merge as F. These 4 going to merge at F. Now we can go to the edit of object mode and we can see everything is came perfectly. Okay, fine. Our handle has been ready, so I save the cup. So I make it as photo cup. So now this one, I'm going to save it as photo cup. Okay, now okay, audio also it's recording, I just checked. Okay, now we can give some coloring for this. I press Control 3 to make it and it looks fine. So we have to now do the unwrapping for this. I select these edges, this edge I select is the front view, no? Right, this edge I select and this edge I select, and I press F5 to mark seam. Right click and you can able to see mark seam and clear scheme. I have added the shortcuts. You can add the shortcuts using like this, right click and assign a shortcut, and you can assign which key is required for you. And here I'm going to mark this as separate seam, so which is the 4 F5, and this and the edges I'm going to mark it as seam. I do one thing, select all, shift N, control inside. Okay, now you can able to see everything is showing correctly, and this edges we can do one thing. So I mark this also a separate thing to shift Z to you can see. I'm going to make it this also, make it separate F5, and I use this also mark a seam, so we can make it unwrap it perfectly, these three. Now here we can make these edges and these edges we can mark seam and to unwrap it correctly. So now outside and inside it's marking correct, and I'm going to mark this one and this one also, it's separately F5. So now I go to the unwrap menu. Now we have created some seams, everything. I select everything, I press U to unwrap it. Now we can able to view everything has came correctly. So for me, which is not required, I tell you here, the shape which is required for us, this is one. So I select this scenarization and I select this in edge selection mode. I press period key, so it's inside, no it's outside only. So I press Control L to mark a seam. You can able to see it's coming like circle, so which is not required for us like that. And we can see this one is, I think so, it's a handle, right? Fine. Now what we have to doing, go to the edge selection and zoom it, select this edge and this edge. Now I'm going to mark it as seam, and I press A to select all, U to unwrap it. Now it has been unwrapped perfectly. So I'm going to align this one, this I just control space, I'm going to align this unwrapped thing shapely correctly. So what I'm going to do is, I'm going to press 3 on the keyboard. This has been aligned perfectly shape. So selecting that, I press Control L, right click, and I'm going to do follow the active squats. So now this has been straightened for us, and now what I'm going to do is, right click, I will show you one example. So right click and you can make it split is Alt M by selection. Okay, now I press Control space to zoom out. Now what I'm going to do is, sorry, I created wrongly the seam is, I do one thing, I press Control Z Z Z Z Z Z Z Z Z. Okay, now actually for us it's required, the unwrapping is here, this one and this one, select these two. So this one we have to unwrap. Yeah, I press F5, And I'm going to give the texturing in front, not all over the cup. So what shall we do is we can make a mark towards this. Okay, we can give fully also, it's not a big matter. Okay, so now I select everything, you to unwrap it. Now I select the center shape and I press Ctrl L, right click and follow the active squares. Now it has been straightened. So I select these edges. Okay, we can give some more design for this. Okay, I got one more idea. So I select this one, I press Ctrl L, G to move. Now I select this everything, Ctrl L, and scale it down, so which is not required for us. So G to move towards here, and I select this one and L to select everything, R to rotate, I press Ctrl like this to move, and G to move. So I'm moving the scale like this, and I'm going to take this one and I press G, I move it here. I'm going to align this one properly. Now what to do is press one on the vertices selection, right click, align by X, select this, align by X, select the top, right click, align by Y, right click, top, align by Y. So now it has been aligned perfectly shape. Select this, press Ctrl L and right click, follow the active swatch. So now the all the shape has been came correctly. And here what I'm going to do is I'm going to give a separate design for that. So we can think how to give the both image and texturing for this. For that I have one idea. So I hope this will work out, I think so. So let me try that, I have got one idea. Okay, I press A to select all and UV, export UV layout, and I go to the layout section. I am going to leave it as cup layout. So I am 1024 I am doing. So I export the UV. Now I save this one, I go to the shading section, and I create a new texture. So I just reduce it down, so because I want to show you the cup, and I just apply some red color and I reduce the roughness. So this here is our cup is ready. So this is our basic design cup. So inside we can give some more color also if required. So that one how to do is we can go to the new thing again, we can create, we can make it is just this is as base, and I create one more thing and add it, and I click new. This is inside I make it, and this one let it be white. I go to the edit mode, I press Ctrl space, and I select this using alt key and everything, or we can make it like this. I go to the vertices select, I press and press Ctrl plus 2, add it like this. Okay, and I press 3 on the keyboard the face selection, and I go for assign button, selecting this inside and assign it, and I go to object mode. Now you can able to look inside, it's a different color. So this is not a what is a sweater color, I reduce and increase the roughness. So now it look like so I reduce the roughness a little bit, fully reduce it, let's see what happens. Okay, fine. So our basic cup has been ready with the designs. So here what we are going to do is we are going to import a pictures and everything to do some designing. I open a GIMP tool, so which I have given in the description link to download the GIMP application. It's open source, So Blender also it's open source. I'm designing in 2.9. So go to the section here and I create new, which I'm going to give 1024 by 1024. Now I just disable this background and I go to the open as layer and I go to the layout section and I'm going to open this layout which is required for us to align it, and I create a new layer. I'm going to give some designs here. So I select this and I lock this one. Okay, here I create one shape here using a rectangle tool. I make it reduce like this, and I'm going to give it the color is and I make exactly the same size. Okay, and I take this two. And I make this one as white. So I paint it in white. No, I do one thing. I paint it in green. So which is going to be 00FF00 in the HTML code. And I click OK. And I go to the paint tool. I'm going to paint here. Now I go to the select option. Now selected. Control C to copy and paste. Now I move it like this. Control copy C to V to paste. I move like this. And I press enter. Go to the other selections and guys shift A. And I go here and I apply a layer thing. Okay. Now here what I am going to do is, here I am going to give one here we can do with separate options that adding a photo and giving the some other colors. So what we can do is we can add the photo here. So we have to align the photo inside the cup. So the balance thing which one is required for us is the we have to give some more color for this. So here okay, this is the end of the cup, right? So we can use the different color, but we can give this one differently. How to do? I'm just confused. So now we can add the image directly here, or we can add it in the layout. So that is the thing now we are I'm thinking about. We can add the image texture in layout means, so this one we give it fully red means, how the other background will be tied up. If we mark this completely as red means, then we can add the image photo. That image which is not there on other side is, we can make it as color now. Here in this middle okay, not a big matter, because this is the thing which we are going to give is at I'm totally confused now. We can give the red color, or what red color if we given in the angles, if we design red color, we can give some image particular section, we are giving some images. So in that image which we can use for so once that is one up here is applied, then now we can make it how can apply one textures for that to apply correctly. Okay, better we can give the pictures here itself. So I go to file and open as a layer. So I have saved some files for my images. So this is my image. So I just move towards here. So which is going to be the same like this. So this off will be coming photo and the rest of thing will be black, so which we can mark like this. So half thing will come photo like this. So I make it move like this, so it will come like this. Okay, fine. Now I just make this layer little bit up. Okay, so we can able to move easily the photo to assign as a layer. Okay, now I turn off this one and this one. Oops. Okay, there is the two layer which one is coming should be up towards here, or I go up. Okay, everything has been disabled using that. Very bad, very bad, very bad. I make this one down. Why this is not coming? I go down. Okay, now this has been created perfectly. So okay, I turn off this. Okay, now I turn on this and I go for this and I just so I have used the shift key and moved like this. Okay, fine. Now we can zoom it. And I go for the selection and I selected this one and control copy C to paste and move this one here again the same. And copy paste, I move this one here and I apply as a new layer. So now I turn off this. Okay, now everything has came correctly. I turn off these two and see this one. Okay, fine. So now our photo has been imported and we have given one design here to make it work perfect. Okay, so now what I'm going to do is I'm going to export this as a PNG in desktop only. I just make it, or I go for the layout only same section and make it cup color layout. And I export it. Okay, exported. I go to the here. I'm going to create one shift A and I search for the image texture and I open the image texture which is there in the layout section, cup CL colored, and I can show you here what's there inside. Okay, now I have created the textures like this. Here I'm going to create a RGB, which is I'm going to select separate RGB. So here what I'm going to do is I'm going to create a one more node as math. There I'm going to make it subtract and going to give the value 0. And I'm going to connect this one green here. So green which is there for us. Now I create here on a mix shader, not mix RGB, shift A mix shader, shift A search mix shader, and I connect this value here. And now for the black, what I'm going to do is I'm going to connect this shader for the black thing and I'm going to make it as give yellow and I'm going to connect this shader to the surface. Okay, inside it's greater, right? I selected green, right? Green textures, no repeat. I do one thing, let me create shift D to one more shader. This shader I'm going to connect it here and I'm going to connect it here. So let's see what happens. Okay, now you can able to see the yellow has came correctly here inside. Actually it's required for us, it should be outside, right? Okay, I do want I create one duplicate and I connect this shader to here. So let's see what happens. Again looks the same. Why? Oops, I'm doing it inside now. I did a much big mistake here, so that is the problem. So I deleted everything. I just undo everything. I just take this and cut this one. I go to the base material. Now here I paste it. Okay, copy blow not coming. Okay, image texture. Sorry, I did it in wrong material. So that's the reason it's not taken. So let's see here. I go to this color and I'm going to mark this as Shift A search RGB. Sorry, Shift A mix shader. Here make it and Shift A for search for math. So this one I'm going to separate it at zero value and I create one more node called which is RGB, which is going to, I'm going to select separate RGB and I'm going to select this color to image. Here green I'm giving as a value and I'm going to fact, and that fact I'm going to give like this first shader, and this shader I'm going to connect it here. Now I go for this, I go to the edition like this. Now here you can able to see the green one which is came is black. Sorry, I selected wrongly. Now you can able to see the image one which has came black is outside is the black. And I make this red. So here my photo is here, so I'm going to rotate this one correctly for the layout, so that we can do it later. So we can increase the value to 230 and it looks like this, very blur. Okay, 0.230 and I make it as 0 again. So now this shader has been created. I duplicate one more thing, I connect like this. So let's see how it works. Okay, still it comes the same. So the green value, it's respecting the other things. So green only for us required. So let me, I have one idea, so let me try that one. So I separate this one red. I'm going to minus this one, and this one here, and make it green. Now this one I'm going to change it here. Multiply and so let me see creating the three color and see how it works. So we are doing some RDS here. Oops, it's showing red. Okay, right, I know why it's showing red. This shader need to go here. But it still comes the same. I make it white. Okay. Now the green value which is required is for us. This is comes need to come to here for the green value. So blue value need to go here. Okay. Okay, now understand that RGB channel, the green channel which comes with all the mixing color. So that's the reason this option is not suitable for us. Okay, this has been not came correctly for us. So what I'm going to do is, I have one more idea to do this. And I select by color, make it this one. Acquire Shift A, select none. Invert and select none, and Ctrl Shift A to select none, and I select by color. I right click and merge down the layer, and select by color. Now it's everything has been selected, and I change it to white. And select by white. Better, I'm having one idea. So two separate layer we can make it. Okay, so this one I turn off, and this background also I turn off. And this one let it be one more image, the same, and we can give the color for that better. That is, we can make it separate is better. So this material is going to be the solid view here. So this one is inside, let it be inside. I assign this, and this is the base material. I press Ctrl I to invert selection, and I assign it as material. Now I go to the view, and the black one. Now, so we have to do exactly what is required for us, right? So the black one, if we give, means it's contrast to even our eye also, it's black, right? So it will get changed. So we can do one thing. Now this material I'm going to make it as red, and I go for the material preview. Now it's coming like this. So I do one thing, I select everything and I delete it and go for the image. I select this one as base color. I mark it like this. Let me see what it comes. So now our image has been came. I do one thing, I go with open this. And I go to the desktop, not desktop, right? I go to the layout, and cup color I change it once again. Now we can able to view this color is coming. Okay, now the cup has been came and I go to the UV editing and I select this one. Now I go to the rendering view, I select everything and R to rotate, I use the control key to rotate like this and G to move. I move like this, okay. So I make it as front like this, that is better. Okay, this is the front cup, na? Right. So how I'm going to do is I'm going to press G to move towards here. Now I'm going to give like this. Okay, go to the edit mode and I press G to move towards here and we can see how it comes. So rest of the thing is coming black. So for that we got one more idea to change the color backside. Let's see that is working. I go for the shading again. Okay, press Ctrl Z. Z white and let me add one mixer and see. Mixer it doesn't came correctly, so this is better. We can make it as black cup. So here we can add the photo here. So instead of this black, we can change the color. Some option we have to give. Make it black, it look nice. So I go to the UV editing and I press GX to move towards like this, or GX to move towards like this. Okay, I press N on the keyboard to see the scale, everything is correct. Okay, fine, our basic cup has been ready and here we can able to see all and go to the selection and we can see the rendering is okay. Press G to move, so everything is moving correctly, right. Fine, so for us now this has been ready. So cup with photo. I go to the solid view. I go for the rendering view and I turn on the light section. I press Ctrl Alt 0 and I press N on the keyboard and go to the view and lock the camera view and I turn it like this. Okay, and I do the rendering for this. Okay, this is the video, it's completed. So if you like the video, you can give the like button. And next up, I will guide you how to change the background and the photo without getting affected. So I check and I will do the needful for you. So next video we can see that one section. So bye bye, until that.